Previously on The Mole. Nine players began a series of tasks raising money for the pot that the winner will eventually take home. The current pot is at $39. However, one of these players is the mole, hired by me to secretly sabotage the group's efforts. It's up to the players to figure out who the mole is, because at the end of each round, they have to take a 10-question quiz on the mole's identity. The player with the lowest score in this quiz is executed and must leave the game immediately.
Alright, congratulations guys. Now it's down to six and three people are already gone. So it's time for task number five. Solve these three puzzles. And if you solve all three of them, then they'll know the exact bingo to choose and $10 will be added, okay? Alright, go.
Literally had no idea what I was doing in that test.
The first couple minutes we didn't know what we were doing at first. Okay.
These
minutes.
Ones?
It's not
3 minutes left.
It's not these two.
I think we were just, I don't know, just putting some stuff together, and then we eventually did get it. Gabe was helping me a lot.
And
okay. And what you're doing?
I'm just like whenever cards match, I'm just like matching them. And then
take that one.
Bottom right and top right. Two.
Bottom right, top right.
1 minute 30 seconds left. Babe.
Three, that one, and
okay,
this one.
Oh,
so it's
this.
Wait, we got it!
So you guys added $10 to the pot.
I'm almost confident it's Sarah. I'm kind of leaning more now towards Alina.
So for this task, you're gonna have to fill out a 10-question survey, asking questions that vary from who's more likely to develop a drug addiction to who has the best voice.
Just the people that are left?
Yes, so you must answer with the name of someone who's left in the game.
And you guys are gonna have to answer who you think got the most votes for each question. For every question that at least four people are right and who got the most votes for the answering of that question, $1 will be added to the pot. Most likely to develop a drug addiction was Anna.
Yeah, we sucked that one up.
Yeah? Okay. How many people would put Sarah?
Shit.
Oh, I put Sarah on the test, I forgot.
How many people put Sam?
Really, guys?
Come on.
Most likely to get married during college. Who put Alina?
Yes. We only earned $1 out of 10. And then Sam, Sarah, and Anna asked for an exemption, so that also took away a couple bucks.
I kind of think Sarah now. Either Sarah or Gabe.
My alliance!
Yeah. Unless...
Oh. Sarah, please come to faith.
You
are
the most fourth victim.
Oh my god, it was her!
Five remain, but only one will win. The one who answers the question, who is the mole? Can you figure it out? Who is the mole?
I'm really surprised that Sarah got out because I was almost like, I was sure that she was gonna be the mole. So now it's a toss up. Like, I feel like I was leaning towards Gabe, but then I feel like he's being too cocky about it.
Okay, so I'm really upset that Sarah got voted off because I was in an alliance with her. Luckily, I knew that I could trust her, thankfully. I wasn't playing my cards wrong. And everyone that I still suspect, which is down to, there's only like five of us now, but I have it down to Gabe, Alina, or Marissa. And I'm still kind of leaning towards Gabe. Only because he stayed pretty quiet. And, you know, he doesn't offer any opinion when we do tasks. Like, if it was hard or, you know, like anything like that, or he doesn't, like, assign himself a position.
I really thought she was gonna make it far. It's kind of surprising. Strategy going on. I don't really trust anybody. And I'm just gonna keep pretty much a strategy I have been doing the whole time. Just keep to myself and observe. everyone else.
I totally thought it was Sarah.
How did she do worse?
It means you're the mole.
I feel like a lot of people.
Maybe you guys.
Yeah, we said if Sam didn't get out,
she's really the mole, and she's still here. So that was surprising. Kinda thought Sarah was the mole, like 49%.
I was really shocked. I kept saying to you, I was like,
yeah,
I think it's her. So now I don't know, really. I guess I'm gonna go back to my original thought of Alina and maybe Anna.
Who thinks Sam is the mole?
I don't know.
I don't even know anymore.
Definitely.
What is life?
I suspect they're still here.
Really? Yeah. Well, the first person that I thought of is still here.
Yeah.
Pretty sure I was the first person.
As my suspicion goes, everyone's still here, so it's like,
shoot. I feel like Marissa could be it, but she seems too nervous during like elimination, so I'm not sure.
Congratulations, you guys are top 5 in the game.
Nice.
I don't feel like it.
Now, before we start task number 7, the last task of the day, we are going to have a quick vote. I want you guys to vote for who you would like to see go home next.
Oh.
Okay. Now, one by one, we're going to reveal them.
Oh my god,
so
Gabe, who do you want to see go home next?
Oh.
Sam.
Alina?
Oh,
okay.
Alina. Babe.
Oh, Alina. Marissa.
Marissa!
Marissa.
Gabe.
Alright, so Gabe,
yeah,
you were voted that you
Marissa?
Want to see,
oh,
you
Anna.
Want to be seen going home next. So, you can take your bags from the basement because you're not going to be sleeping in the basement, and you get an exemption, which means you made it to the next round.
No!
So you're going to be sleeping in our luxury suite upstairs in Brian's room alone instead of in the crowded basement, and you don't have to do task number 7. The next task is the time limit. You guys decide it pretty much, but it could be up to an hour. And
I thought staying up that
long. Does anyone here know what a flamingo contest is?
Standing on one leg?
Yes.
Oh no!
So what you're gonna have to do is have 3 out of the 4 of you standing with one leg in the air at all times for up to an hour. And for every 6 minutes that 3 out of the 4 of you are standing, $1 will be added to the pot.
You get to take breaks.
You get to take breaks, but make sure when you're changing players that 4 people are standing before one person goes down. Ready? The 60 minutes starts. Leg up.
Wait, 60. Oh.
60 minutes.
Now. I did that one.
60 minutes.
We
all right, movie
did
start.
That's as long as you can.
No. Alright, I'm gonna put the timer here so you can
start the movie.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
No.
I don't know why I started on my left leg first. That was stupid.
No, my left leg's my better leg.
Alright, the timer's here so you guys can look at it.
I did that one.
This
is like
that was me. I started this hall.
I'm not gonna lie to you.
Are we turning up the light?
Alright guys, you just passed the 12 minute mark, so you guys have $2 out of the possible chance so far. So if you don't, in 48 minutes, maybe it's about $10.
Yes. All right,
guys,
not even for 30
you just
minutes
reached
watching
the 30 minute mark, which means that you have raised $5 for the 5 out of the possible 10. So if you keep going for a half an hour, you get all $10. You guys can go down because Anna went down before Marissa stood up.
Alright, you know what, you little shit.
The time is ended and there's 8 minutes 20 seconds left on the clock, which means that you guys raised $8 out of the possible 10. So at the end of day 1, the pot is up to $47. And tomorrow, out of the possible around 60, 62.
How is test 7?
It was tiring, but I don't really have any new suspicions because the person I suspect is Gabe right now, and he didn't participate, so I don't really know.
Tiring.
We got a possible $8 out of $10. Because Marissa and Anna messed up trying to get up and down. But that's still a good amount. We went for 52 minutes.
Task 7 was very boring, to say the least. I mean, it was very, like, exhilarating in any sort of way, and it wasn't very hard. We got out on a stupid mistake, and I think I can rule out that any of the girls are the mole. I think my suspicions are really now pointed towards Gabe, only because none of us purposely, I mean, it would have been really easy for the mole to have, like, won themselves money if it was one of us four girls.
I'm really tired now. It was right. It actually wasn't as bad as I thought it was gonna be. We got a lot of breaks, so that was good.
Did it raise any suspicions?
No.
Okay.
I don't think so.
So how was your night last night?
It was long. Didn't really sleep very much. The floor was very hard. And John was talking in his sleep. He was talking about Tyler Lyons and and counting beans. That's what he said. So yeah, that was fun.
How was your night besides getting sick?
My night was okay. I got to sleep on a little futon, so it was much better than everyone else's.
So how is the morning so far? How's breakfast?
Breakfast was quiet. Everyone was tired.
I didn't get much sleep. It was cold, but it was good. It was funny. John talked in his sleep. Yeah.
Do you think a lack of sleep is putting you in a bad position to start today's event?
I'm used to it.
So, how was your night last night?
It was good. I didn't really sleep much, but it was good. So
how was your night last night?
Not bad. I probably was the only person that got some real sleep because I got exiled, so peaceful. Didn't have to hear some people talking about beans or laughing, so that was nice.
Welcome to day two. I hope you guys had a good sleep.
I had a good sleep.
I know Gabe probably did.
Oh, good.
So now it's time for task number 7, I think, right?
I think it's 8.
8? Yeah, task 8. Okay.
Gabe!
So for this task, instead of working as a group for money, this time you're just going to work as individuals, playing for the chance to use your notebook on the next execution quiz, because everyone else is not allowed to use their notebook.
The next execution quiz that I'm exempt from?
Yes, which is why, Gabe, if you win it, you have the chance to give your notebook and let someone else use their notebook on the quiz, so you can help someone out.
Oh.
The players begin by throwing a ping pong ball into a cup. The first four to do that advance to a short word puzzle. The first three to correctly answer that must roll number 5 on a dice 3 times, and then complete a puzzle. The first player to finish the puzzle wins.
Go.
Oh, geez. We got it in.
Oh,
I
wasn't guessing for some.
Oh, damn. Johnny, give me a ball.
Oh, cool. Johnny, give me a ball.
Wait, where do I go?
No.
Here.
No.
Where's your pen?
Sam.
Who got it in?
Oh.
I just don't throw
it
in. You're really bad at this.
Go! Somebody's not gonna make it to the next round.
Messed that one.
Wait, Gabe, you're
going to do
this. Sam! Go, Gabe, get it in! Oh.
Gabe doesn't even need to get it in. Like, he's already exempt from the quiz.
Oh my god, this table's messing me up.
Go, Gabe, go!
No!
What happened to my superior physics knowledge? Physics!
You
got it 5 times, Marissa?
Yeah.
Thanks.
Oh.
Three.
No, it's five times!
No.
Go, Lena! Go, Anna! No preference.
Four.
Okay, you're out. Alina, go. Quick.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh.
You got it.
You'll see.
One, two, three.
I know it's five times. Five.
Just go. Oh.
Did Sam get one?
Yeah. Oh, you mean that one? You don't have to go for it.
Sam, you suck.
Yeah. It's pretty close.
Only a couple pieces left.
How
was
that?
I'm missing a piece.
Maybe it's on the floor.
Alright, stop. Now, Marissa, because you won, you have the chance to use your notebook during the quiz. Or you can add $3 to the pot and make an even $50. So you have to decide right now, would you rather not use your notebook during the quiz, or would you rather add $3 to the pot?
$3.
You're just saying that because
she volunteers.
No, I want my notebook.
You want your notebook?
Wow, second time she took it.
Alright.
Okay, guys.
So
I just did task 8, I think, or 7, I'm not sure. I won, and I chose to use my notebook instead of add $3 to the pot, and they all hate me again. They think I'm the mole, which is really funny.
It was pretty good. I got in second place. Marissa got in first, and then she picked to use her notebook for the quiz instead of adding $3 to the pot.
But the game was hard. I'm very bad at ping pong. I don't get a lot of practice.
Mm.
This morning was alright. The challenge was, I was disappointed that I didn't get the ping pong ball in first, considering, you know, all of my experience with balls.
Mm.
Yeah, that was tough.
Yeah, Marissa.
That was like the third time she didn't do that.
Why are you not taking the money?
Because I want my notebook.
She's the mole.
She's the mole!
It's now time for the fourth execution quiz, 10 questions about the mole. The player with the lowest score in this quiz will be the mole's fifth victim. Question number 1, is the mole male or female?
I'm still kind of leaning towards Gabe. During the tests, he never really says if it's hard or not. So I'm leaning more mostly towards him, but I keep putting down that I think it's a female. Because there's more females.
2. What grade is the mole in?
The flamingo challenge was kind of difficult. My knee like locked up, but the fact that Gabe wasn't participating in it, like, kind of, I'm suspecting him, so it didn't really help me.
3. Did the mole sleep upstairs last night?
What's your strategy at this point?
Just to see who's being the most suspicious and maybe to try to get exempt again.
4. At breakfast, what did the mole put on their bagel?
I mean, it was hard, but I don't really need the notebook. I mean, I write down important things, but I really just write down suspicions in my notebook. I don't really write down like what went on the tasks, only because I can remember that kind of stuff. So I don't think it's like a disadvantage, at this point, but when I'm taking the quiz, I'm probably going to want it, but I'm not really that concerned.
5. In task 7, did the mole start in flamingo position?
The fact that Marissa won and didn't take the $2 kind of makes me suspicious, because this is like not the first time she's not like taken like something for herself instead of the money, so it makes me kind of suspicious of her.
6. Who did the mole want to see go home next?
Well, because I have an exemption, I really don't care. So, just gonna look forward to the next one.
7. Did the mole sleep in a sleeping bag last night?
I'm gonna go back to my original thought of Alina and maybe Anna, but I don't know. I feel like I don't know. I just don't know.
8. In task 8, did the mole roll the dice?
Do you have any strategy going forward?
Right now, not really. I'm just gonna try to answer the quizzes as general as possible. So like, not pinpoint one person so then I can answer the most questions right. So if I am wrong about it, I won't get all the questions wrong.
9. Up to date, has the mole received an exemption?
I'm surprised that Marissa opted to take her notebook instead of the money, which makes me have more suspicions on her.
And question number 10, who is the mole?
Then there were 5.
Who's on the couch?
Okay. Right now there are 5 of you guys left in the game, and Gabe, you have an exemption, which means you automatically advance to the next round. Alright, let's begin. Sam.
You're the most fifth victim. Please come with me.
I know Craig had a certain amount of luck.
What is your reaction to being the most fifth victim?
I'm so sure. 100% sure. I don't want to be cheaped out though. Like, I'll go down there and go get the $2, but then I don't want someone to say that they're gonna do that and then not do that. Yeah.
Well, we'll see you later today where you'll actually find out who the mole is and who the winner of the game is.
Shocked?
I guess if she didn't go home,
she was definitely the mole.
Yeah.
Good. What do you think about her being the first person to be called and being out?
I liked that.
Final four. What?
Nobody expected that.
Yeah.
Was it suspenseful?
No, it's not.
Were you relieved? Were you?
I was relieved that.
So, no, round of applause. Final four.
Final four.